Welcome to Christ Revival Evangelistic Ministries, also known as Sanctuary Praise Church. Here's a message that will establish the truth of God in your life by Evangelist Victor Ajishefe.
There is no other message now, no other message except the message of preparing the bride of Christ to meet with him. Judgment is coming very soon. The great separation of the sheep from the goat will take place any moment from now. The trumpet shall sound. Please, I'm imploring us. I'm encouraging us this morning. We need to live prepared. Be prepared. Amen. That is a home for us. That is a home. Heaven is home. One day, just as we are here, we are also going to be in heaven, those who are prepared. And those who despise messages like this, those who choose to love the world and think they can love the world and love God at the same time, do you know where they will be? They will be in hell. Also, they will be there forever and ever in torment. The reason why God brings us a church like this is for your soul to escape the judgment that is coming upon this world. It's to escape the anger of God. It's for us to escape hell so that heaven can be our home. Everything you have right now, everything I have right now, they are all vanity. The only thing that is precious about me is my soul. Every other thing that I have, they are all vanity. Is that what you want to sacrifice heaven for? 1 John 3, 8, Pastor. 1 John chapter 3 and verse 8.
He that committed sin is of the devil.
You see? Whoever continues to sin after the blood of Jesus has been shed for you, after you have answered altar call and say you give your life, after you say you give your life to Christ, how can you still continue to live the way you want to live? He that continues to sin, whoever continues to sin, belongs to the devil, which means the devil will come for you. Yes. Don't be in sin. And one pastor is telling you, you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. When you are in sin, Jesus did not save us in sin. He saved us from sin. He died to liberate us from sin. Finish reading verse 8. Read the verse 8, Pastor.
He that committed sin is of the devil.
Period. Go on.
For the devil sinned from the beginning.
He was the one that sinned from the beginning. He sinned in heaven and he was chased out of heaven. Go on. Finish reading that scripture. Let's hear it.
For this purpose the Son of God was manifested.
For lest Satan not harvest to soul. That was why Jesus came. Yes.
That he might destroy the works of the devil.
What is the works of the devil? It is sin. 1 John chapter 3. Verses 2 and 3. 1 John chapter 3. Verses 2 and 3. Yes.
Beloved.
Beloved, my brothers and my sisters. Yes.
Now are we the sons of God.
Now we have given our life to Christ. Say now, my dear friends, we are now God's children. Yes.
And it doth not yet appear what we shall be.
Yes.
But we know that when he shall appear.
When Christ appears. Any moment from now. He shall appear. The Holy Spirit is speaking to you today. When Christ shall appear. Any moment from now. Yes.
We shall be like him.
Oh, we shall be like him. Yes.
For we shall see him as he is.
Shall see him as he is. Yes.
And every man that had this hope in him.
Every one of us that is looking forward to this. Yes.
Purified himself.
Must cleanse himself.
Even as he is pure.
As Jesus Christ is pure. What I am telling you is this. There is nothing like a sinning Christian. If you are a sinner, you are not a Christian. If you are a Christian, you will not be sinning. Brothers and sisters, the night is far spent. The day is about to break. This is not a season for compromise. Sin. The wages of sin is death. Don't be one of the fools who reject the gift of God. This life is a temporal life. Very soon, we shall face eternity. We shall be changed. The trumpet shall sound. Jesus Christ is coming. And the world is at the threshold of judgment. The world shall pass away with fervent heat and everything that is in it. Our own dispensation is going just at the days of Noah. Say, be ye holy, for I am holy. It is Satan that is vile and unholy. And everything that is vile, that is sinful, is satanic. And no unrighteousness shall inherit the kingdom of God. You are hearing it now. Maybe this is your last chance to hear it. There are two things that could close the door against you. It could be rapture. It could be death. Hebrews chapter 9. We start reading from verse 27.
And as it is appointed unto men once to die.
It is appointed unto man once to die. Yes.
And after this, the judgment.
The judgment of God. The judgment of God. Do you know the purpose of the love of God? The purpose of the love of God is to deliver us from the judgment of God. Do you know why God is loving you? God loves you to deliver you from his judgment. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So that those who believe in him should not perish. So the love of God is to deliver you from judgment. Your loving God is for you to avoid iniquity. The love of God is not freedom to live as you want. It is too dangerous. God is sending this word to us so that you and I can escape. You not go say, you know, Yeri, or they not be tell you. He became sacrifice to take away sin. To take away sin. He said in the same manner, Christ also was offered in sacrifice once to take away the sin of many. He should take the sin away, my brothers and sisters. This is the gospel. Because heaven does not understand sin. Do you know why? The Son of God has been crucified. He was crucified not wearing clothes on the cross. Huh? You can't be a Christian and you co-inhabit and you are living with a man that is not your husband. Or you are living with a woman that is not your wife. And then you come to church and sit comfortably on your way to hell. And then somebody is there fooling you and deceiving you that you are okay. You are not okay. Because if the trumpet sound, you won't go. And if die meet you, because anybody can die anytime. You know, but good people, the way you be sabi, you age mate, you schoolmate, you workmate. Many of them have died. They've gone. Many people have gone this year. Where will you show up? How prepared are you to meet the Savior? How will you face eternity? When the time is up, where are you going to show up? Luke chapter 13. In Luke 13, 23.
Then said one unto him.
Somebody came to Jesus and said to him, yes.
Lord.
Master.
Are there few that be saved?
No, so it is just few people that will be saved. It's a long time. The Bible says in the days of Noah, few were saved. Oh, I feel God this morning. I feel his presence. In the days of Noah, The man preached for 120 years about the coming flood that will judge the world. Do you know that only 8 human beings were saved? When tortoise reached inside the ship, Noah's ark, tortoise reached there, ant reached there, snail reached there, because there was enough time for everybody to be saved. God has been so patient all these years, so that no soul will perish, so that even ant go reach inside the ark, even snail will reach inside the ark, Mr. Tortoise will reach inside the ark, all animals will reach. Only 8 human beings were saved because of the kind heart we will get. Is that the kind of heart that you get, that you have? Hey, if the trumpet should blow right now, how many of these people that I'm preaching to will go to rapture? And Jesus said, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. Like a thief in the night, he shall come. So there was somebody that asked Jesus, when they said, Master, how many people shall be saved? Just a few will be saved. Look at the answer of Jesus. Yes, go on.
And he said unto them.
And Jesus answered.
Strive to enter in at the straight gate.
If you are going to be part of those that will go, you must strive. You must labor. You must try. Strive to enter in. And he said, do your best. I like this translation. He said, Master, is it just few that will be saved? Think about it. When some will go and some will be left. Think about it. If death comes and you show up in hell, when you could have made heaven. So do your best. Then somebody asked, Master, is it just a few people that will be saved? Now Jesus said, do your best to go in through the narrow door. You have to be streamlined. You have to be focused. You have to be serious. You have to be diligent. And washing your life. Cleaning up your life. He said, do your best to go through the narrow door. Yes, Pastor, go on.
Strive to enter in at the straight gate.
Uh-huh.
For many, I say unto you,
Baku, go try, yes,
will seek to enter in.
They will seek to enter.
And shall not be able.
So man, when rapture will take place, when people are going, he go say, hey, he go time for jump. I say, no. Look, read this scripture. Do your best to go in through the narrow door. Because many people will surely try to go in, but will not be able. Go on, Pastor.
When once the master of the house is risen up,
when it yes,
and had shut to the door,
when the door has closed, today you are hearing it. You the hear it now. Oh yes. Oh yes. You are hearing the sound. You the hear it today. He said the time will come that the master will come in and close the door. Yes.
And ye begin to stand without.
Those of you that are outside, yes?
And to knock at the door.
You begin to knock the door. I mean, they go to church, yes?
Saying.
And saying.
Lord, Lord.
Lord.
Open unto us.
Please open the door for us. As many people were knocking the door, after God had closed the door of the ark, yes, many were outside knocking. Noah, I mean, you fumble, I mean, you party, but do you have, but I'll not be mean, I'll not be mean. You be the talker. The door has been shut. Go on. This is the same thing that Jesus is warning us about here. Go on, Pastor.
Lord, Lord.
They will say, Lord, Lord.
Open unto us.
Uh-huh.
And he shall answer.
And Jesus will say to you that day. Today he say, let everyone that will come. Let everyone that have ears, let them listen. That day, Jesus will now say to you, go on.
I know you not.
I don't know you.
Whence ye are.
I don't know you, where you're coming from. You work and say to me, Holy Communion. Smart into me, Holy Communion. Smart into me, Holy Communion. The time is coming. The time is coming. Your Holy Communion. Not so. Your Sunday church. To me, first Sunday. To me, first Sunday. Why? I know they miss. Many shall come. I listen to preacher. I go church. I get membership card. I pay tithe. Yes?
But he shall say,
I tell you,
I know you not whence ye are.
I don't know you. Yes, go on.
Depart from me.
Get away from me.
All ye workers of iniquity.
You workers of iniquity. You lover of sin. Go on, pastor.
There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
There'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Suffering and sorrow in the day of judgment.
Thanks for listening, and I believe you've been transformed remarkably. For more information, you can call on these numbers 078-593-977 or 078-595-977, or visit us at the Sanctuary Grace Church, Soweit Drive, off King Hammond Road, Brookfields, Freetown, Sierra Leone. Thank you, and God bless you.